This is Daniel Young for Adaptive Perspective, and I am back to filming content where I can, when I can. I had this thought earlier today and didn't really ruminate or overthink it at the time, knowing that I would be in the car later at night, so here we go. Normally, when I talk about finances, I talk about finances in terms of ships, and I use a lot of nautical references because it makes sense to me. We sail waters, we go through storms, we try to dodge obstacles, and we navigate our way through finances one waypoint to the next. But if that doesn't filter itself out in your brain and you want a different analogy, maybe a different metaphor, you could try thinking about it in terms of a board game, or really in terms of a battle-based strategy game, whether board game or not. So if you think of team-based or individual-based battle games, like really fun to play strategy games, Monopoly, Hand and Foot, and Hand and Foot's a card game, team-based and also individual-based. So Monopoly, Hand and Foot, Cards, Jokers, Marbles, which is kind of the XL, beefed-up, destructo version of Sorry. Same thing, you can play it individually, you can play it as a team. When you look at iconic battle-based games, whether board game or card game, there's a set of rules that goes along with it, and then there are house rules. It's kind of the rules that come with the game. Are you a traditionalist, or are you slightly twisting the rules based upon how your family plays the game? And that's pretty much adapted perspective. I mean, finances-wise, there's the traditional system, the traditional game of money, or money game, of what everybody's given, of what the common, everyday, down-to-earth, average Joe whoever knows about money. And as you slowly progress your way through the game, you slowly learn more about money, how to improve your management of money, how to improve your tactics, how to improve your strategy, or maybe that you're playing the game wrong. Or maybe not wrong, but definitely there's a better way to play it than how you were taught. And that's the adapted perspective ideal. It's everybody's got a financial game they're playing. Everybody's got a financial end that they want to accomplish. So if you look at the overall purpose to what you're doing, if you look at the dreams you want to accomplish, and you look at the overall strategy that allows you to get from where you are to where you want to be, everybody has something in those terms. Now, you might have bad strategy, you might have no idea where you're really going, but you still have dreams or things that you want to accomplish in life. Not like, I just want to go skydiving, like really big stuff. Like, I want to live on a houseboat the rest of my life. Or I want to live in the mountains and live in a cabin and live completely off-grid. And I talk about it all the time. I want to manage my own deer ranch. And by my own, I mean with my family. Not like I'm going to ditch my family. But I want the deer ranch. I want a successful business. And I want that to be my full-time job. So whatever your dreams are, there's got to be a strategy out there for you to get from point A to point B. And culture's strategy is that you go to school, you learn to think inside a box, get trained to exist on a schedule, go to college, learn more about whatever it is you want to do, maybe go to grad school, maybe get a PhD or some form of doctorate. And eventually you get a full-time job. And then you're in that full-time job from whenever you start, whatever age, right? If you're incredibly brilliant, you just start earlier than everybody else. So from whenever you start till 65 plus, and then you get to have fun with life. But what if there was a different way? Like, what if you could accomplish the other stuff sooner? What if there was a better way than the traditional 9 to 5 for 40 plus years? And there is. There's lots of different ways you can go about it. There's tons of strategy on the internet and on, not even just on the internet, there's tons of strategy if you just talk to people. It's just integrating that into a strategy that works for you. And that's where we came up with the 12 steps. We started the Dave Ramsey course, and then we realized it doesn't actually work. Dave Ramsey's system keeps you in the system. It doesn't allow you to leave the system. We wanted something that would get us out of our full-time jobs. And we did a ton of research, listened to a lot of podcast, read some books, still have books to read, still have lots to get to dig into, and we looked at a lot of different things, and we made our own system. 12 steps. I mean, 12 steps to break a habit, right? 12 steps for alcoholism, 12 steps for tobacco, 12 steps for whatever. 12 steps to break an addiction, so why not 12 steps to success? And in making it and in living it, it very much is just steps. And you can think of it as grandiose steps, because that initial phase, that initial research phase of going from the traditional mindset into there's got to be something different. You want to go straight into something, but it really does take some research. And then you realize just how far you have to go. And it seems big, but when you break it down into smaller steps, it's not as big. It's, at some point, I'm going to post pictures of two different ladders. And it's a ladder with rungs that are spaced out every foot versus ladders that are built for Goliath. Right? Goliath can climb a much bigger, broader ladder than everybody else. That doesn't help us. So we just have to realize where we are. We have to identify where you want to go. And then it's finding the right strategy to get you from point A to point B. And it's also the reality that point B is not the end of the map. It is not you find Treasure Island and you die on the island. Point B is just the next waypoint on your journey. Right, so it's getting from where you are to what lifestyle you want to be. And if, I mean, the goal is to hit those treasure islands along the way, to be able to do the stuff as you reach your version of financial freedom. Because if my map only gets me from where I am to Treasure Island, that means I have no strategy, I have no life beyond Treasure Island. I find the treasure. Maybe I enjoy it, maybe I don't, but I find it and I die on the island. Nobody wants that. It is not math class where the shortest distance between two points is a straight line. That is not financial freedom or the journey at all. It is wandering. It seems like you're wasting time as you go around islands, and it seems so far off course to go around that giant sandbar that will just wreck your ship. Right? It's global strategy against other people, if you want to talk in terms of games. It's knowing the destination in the game so that you can strategize your way there. And it's easier when you're playing by yourself. It's also harder when you're playing by yourself. It's easier because you only have to worry about your strategy. It's harder when you're trying to do this the seemingly insurmountable thing on your own. So when you start to work with people, work with your family, work with your friends, when you start to work with people, it's easier to hit the goal, but now it also complicates the journey because you've got more people at play. But it's actually more enjoyable when there are more people along. It's it's funner. It's more interesting. You get to learn more about other people. Now, sometimes you learn some weird stuff, or maybe some, I don't, like, some people have a hard time with small failures or big failures, right? But you learn about people, and then you grow closer to people. And it makes the journey more meaningful. Because at the end of the day, my family, we all of us have individual dreams, individual things we want to accomplish. And we want to help each other accomplish our dreams. But since our dreams are so varied and so wide, like, I mean, I would like property and the successful business, which means we need something else in play that funds our lifestyle while the business becomes successful. My wife's like, well, if we're gonna have the land, I want the house. Agreed. We want some form of residence, permanent residence on that property, and a pool. Pool would be great. My daughter would love, or our daughter would love, a herd of a million cats. And while that's very unrealistic, barn cat, mouse cat, you know, like a mouser cat makes a lot of sense. And I doubt it'll be a million cats. But a place where she can have fun and explore whatever passion she's currently into, whether that be art or a ninja course or anything. Right? My wife and I love classic cars. We would, her dream car is a 1964 and a half Ford Mustang convertible retro mod with a boost, you know, boosted engine and transmission and a automatic shift, which is really not common for that era, but it's something you can do now. So we have all of these varied dreams. There's got to be a bigger strategy at play than just ticking off our dreams on a waypoint system. Right? So from where you are to where you want to exist. So if you look around, so we're back to nautical terminology, or at least nautical metaphor. So if you're standing on the deck of your ship, or pending the size of your ship, if you're just standing anywhere on your rowboat, and you look out, that's your sight. That's what you can see. It's 360 degrees of water or ocean or whatever it is that's around you from your boat. That's the day-to-day stuff, right? That's like you can see the next waypoint. But your vision is always beyond the horizon. You can see the horizon in all directions, but you can't see past it. So the sight is the day-to-day stuff. The vision is what pushes you forward. It's where you're headed. So that vision, or the why, or the overall arching purpose to everything, has to be bigger than the little stuff along the way. So it's, you're trying to figure out where you are. You don't have to, like, lock it down into a specific coordinate. That's not what I'm talking about. You have to realize where you are, your age, current full-time job, your financial abilities right now. And you have to somehow conceptualize where you want to be. What's your version of financial freedom? What is it that you want to accomplish in this life? Like, if you woke up tomorrow and you were 65 and you just retired, what kind of lifestyle do you want to be in? Money invested, property, housing business, car business, successful online money, digital marketing account. Like, what is it that you want to do later? Okay, and then that'll help you form the why of everything. We started off with, well, we want property. Yeah, but how do we get there? We could make a certain amount of money. That doesn't necessarily ensure our ability to keep a property. There's got to be something else there that will fund our property payments in order that we don't have to worry about them. That's certainly not the income we're getting as teachers. And certainly not the income that would come in through teacher retirement. So how do we fund that venture now, and the sooner the better? Complicated question. Seriously, like, you ought to think about yours. So our why of things, our why is not to have property or the car or cars plural or a pool or all the other stuff. Our why is generational wealth. If we can create generational wealth, meaning wealth that is easily passed from us to our daughter, and not just life insurance money, and not just the value of our current assets. If we can set our daughter up to be financially free from the get-go, meaning financially free, let's see. Most people throw the term rich around like it's just this small thing. Hey, that person's rich, that person's rich, that person's rich. Rich is a term of comparison, and it's a term of appearance. That person is richer than me in appearance. If you show up in a Bentley, it doesn't necessarily mean you have money. You can live in a, you know, crap hole, rat infested apartment and drive a Bentley. You can be an NBA star making $10 million and you can spend $10 million and have no money. You can look rich, doesn't mean you are wealthy. Wealthy is a different term. Wealthy is how many days can you go without working a full-time job? If we define terms of wealth, that changes the game. Now, you can still be wealthier than somebody else, and somebody else can still be wealthier than you. But wealth does not equate rich. You can look rich. You are or you are not wealthy. So if we create generational wealth, meaning we set our daughter up from the start to not be limited by a full-time job, then she can still have a full-time job. She can still work wherever she wants to. That's not the point. But if we can build enough up to ensure that we have generational wealth to hand off to her, then whatever property we acquire would be paid for. Or at least there would be assets in place that would be able to cover the monthly payments of owning the property. That way, when we die, it's not a scramble for her to figure out how to make payments for the property. There would be a system already in place, assets producing income already in place, that are covering the monthly payments or whatever payments for the property and everything else. That was a huge realization. It's one thing to buy one investment property. It's one thing to invest in the market. It's one thing to acquire an asset or build a business here and there. It's quite another to create generational wealth in a very short amount of time. So our game, our strategy has been building business. It's been essentially branding business. And it's been learning how to improve our ability in our administration running businesses. It's also been jumpstarting our ownership of assets as opposed to just frivolous shit you buy. It's changed how we play the game. And we are in the midst of our own system. We are building multiple bridges into financial freedom. We are working on adding investment property. We are still working on individual businesses. We are working on a specific strategy for investing into the market. all with the purpose of building generational wealth. So when it comes to, like, everything costs money, right? But when it comes to, hey, could we do this? You really have to, you have to identify your wants and needs. You also have to identify the stuff that you really need to do. Like, it's much easier to take money out of your business and do something else. It's much harder to leave the money there and reinvest it forward into the business. But if we want to grow the business and grow generational wealth, then we need to continue to roll profits forward as opposed to take money out to do other stuff. Like me, so I want the hunting ranch. I want to go and meet Tom McMillan, who is an outfitter in Kansas. And his show on whatever channel, it's McMillan Outfitting. And you get to watch him and his family do all these things. And it's like, quite honestly, and he would agree, I'm sure, you see snippets of his life, but a lot of it is him kind of stumbling his way through fatherhood and running a ranch and having a family. And it's like, you know, if that guy can do it, I'm pretty sure I could do that too. But at the same time, I don't want a TV show. But it's just the overall ability to run a ranch. I would love to go to Kansas and shoot a giant whitetail. Going to Kansas and hunting with Tom McMillan would cost a good chunk of money. But it's also not just the whitetail. I want to see his setup. I would love to talk with him, whether on camera or off. I would love to talk with him and pick his brain about running a successful outfitting business. I mean, how much of the property is his versus how much does he lease or work with other landowners? But really, how does he do it? I mean, he manages thousands of acres. I want to pick his brain on how to run a successful hunting business and see where that challenges what I already know. If it fills in gaps, if it goes against what I've learned so far, I want to give myself the best opportunity to run whatever successful hunting business we're able to set up. It behooves me to talk to people who know how to do that already. So yes, I mean, I'd love to go and shoot a giant whitetail in Kansas. I'd love to go hang out and fish and hunt with Tom McMillan and his family and bring my family along too. But I really just want to go and learn and spend time with him and his family, but spend time picking his brain about the stuff that works really well and why does it work really well. And then talk to him about the stuff that just utterly sucked. Like, tell me a brilliant idea that just bombed. And then tell me why it bombed. And then tell me, did you revamp it into something else or did you shelve it because you found something better? Like, there's nothing. Failure sucks. Nobody likes to fail and nobody likes to suck. But failure is this great teacher where you can then use it to do something else. You can use it to do something amazing. It's a failure in the end of the world. It's that you fail. Now you got to pick yourself back up and try it again. I would love to go learn from Tom McMillan. Love to go learn from Tom McMillan. So it's stuff like that. It's, you have to see a bigger picture. And whether it's a board game or a card game or you're navigating finances or whatever, I mean, you could be strategizing a basketball game or strategizing your competition against somebody else in chess. You have to see the bigger picture. In addition to seeing the next move and even the next second, third, and fourth move that are all based upon other things happening. You have to use strategy to your favor and not just play the game for shits and giggles and play it willy-nilly. It is not happenstance. It is not manifestation. It is not just random occurrence that people are so successful with whatever they're doing. It takes a lot of work. You got to work your ass off for it. So whatever it is that you want to do, whatever it is that you want to do, it's just finding the right strategy and the right bridge to get from where you are to where you want to be and looking at it as not a definitive ending. Like when you win a game of hand and foot, or when you win a game of cards, jokers, marbles, or when you win a strategy game, yes, you might win that actual game. Like you might win Skip Bo for a game, or what is that other game? There's other giant strategy games. But it's... you might be the ultimate victor in that game. However, you're still going to play another game. So it's more like you won that round. You won that way to the waypoint. I got to continue the thing. Now, if you end up winning 34 games in a row, it just means that you've hit 34 mile markers or 34 waypoints in a row. Eventually, you're going to lose. It's just the nature of things. Eventually, you're going to lose, and you're going to have to reformulate and figure it out and see what's wrong, and re-strategize and try to get it. For too long, we have looked at retirement as point A of where you start and point B, it's over. And it's this straight line and it's easy. That is absolute bullshit. And it frustrates the hell out of me. It is a strategy game from the start. And the weak fail. And it's not the strong. The weak absolutely fail. The weak-minded can't see it. But it's not necessarily the strong that win either. It's the ones who persevere. The people who cannot figure out strategy and cannot control their money and cannot play the game, those people lose. But the people who start to wake up and realize there's a bigger thing at play than just managing a paycheck from one end of the month to the next and trying to survive, which we're all, I would wager at least 90% of America is living paycheck to paycheck in some form or other. Right? But the people who start to see a vision greater than the paycheck, who start to see a vision greater than the individual job, working for 40 years, and realize the game of money is a lot different than the game they got taught, they see the battlefield differently. And they create their own house rules, they create their own strategy, and they play the game differently than what's naturally inherent in the game. And that's where you want to get to. It's not that our house is better than somebody else's house, that's more right than somebody else's house's rules. It's not that. It's that we've all realized that you need a better strategy than what comes inside the box. And sometimes you talk with people and it's like, man, that doesn't work at all. But maybe it works for them. Sometimes you talk with people and like, hey, that's a really cool twist. We can add that to how we play. It's all about how you improve your strategy and how you're going to win the game. Not at the complete sacrifice of ethics and morality. Not that. It's all about how you strategize and continue to improve how you play the game. Because if you play the game based upon the box, you'll be working until you're 65, 70, 75, whatever they change it to. Inflation will kill you. Your retirement account will suck. It's not going to be great at all. But if you wake up a little bit and start to realize you need to play the game a little bit differently, then play the game a little bit more differently, and then change your strategy, you will have a much better outcome than if you play by the box's rules. So if you want to talk strategy, if you want to talk bigger picture, if you need help in figuring out how to get from where you are to where you want to be, then I would love to chat with you. Come find me on Instagram. I'll probably post this on YouTube because it's a lot longer than I thought it would be. But come find me on Instagram, same handle, Adapted Perspective, and let's chat. And I don't mean come buy my system and I will help you. I mean come find me on Instagram and find my account and send me a message and let's talk strategy and let's figure out a better way that helps you right? Let's figure out where you are in our 12 steps, and then let's figure out how to improve your strategy and how to improve your game performance. Because that's really what it comes down to. Yes, I love strategy, and yes, I love helping people, but I really want to help you win in your game of money, or in your money game, however you want to say it. I would love to help you. I really want to set you up well. There's a lot of personal work in that. There's a lot of self-ownership. There's a lot of personal responsibility in that. But if you want to talk strategy with somebody and you just want to bounce ideas off somebody, or you want to, honestly, if you want to peek in on my page and see what I'm up to, then yes, come find me on Instagram and let's talk strategy and let's get you started. Because there is a better way than what came in that box. We just got to figure out how to help you and figure out what strategy works best for you. So I hope you have a great night. I need to end this video and finish my drive. So see y'all later. Bye-bye.